All right, welcome back everyone. Now, I wanted to walk through what the double jig setup, a lot of people had questions on what it looked like on my sonar, especially during open water season when I had this exact unit. This is the Humminbird Helix 5 on the bow of my boat. And I use this unit a lot, specifically if I'm just vertically jigging right below the boat. So a lot of people had questions what the double jig setup actually looked like on this sonar. So I tied on the double jig setup on this ice fishing rig. I started off with the bottom jig. This is a 1/16 chartreuse marabou jig. And then this is a 1/64, just a green jig. And I tipped it with a brush pile plastics. So this is a pink and white. Pink, chartreuse, white, three colors that crappie usually hit no matter what. But this is a 27-inch ultralight setup, and I got the new Pisifun ICX5 this year. I got two of them. I'm going to be using these reels quite a bit for ice fishing season, specifically because they're the 500 size. These would also probably be really good for dock shooting. Small spool length would come off them really fast. This is 4-pound mono. This is that 4-pound slime line clear mono. But I wanted to actually show you what it's like to see these on the sonar. I had a few questions about this sonar, just what 2D imaging kind of tells you. So right now I'm in 34 feet of water right here, okay? And everything, they call this the real-time sonar for Humminbird. It's called RTS on the right side here. And basically everything in this column is, as soon as something pings against it, it shows up in that little column of sonar. Everything going from right to left is historical data. Now, normally your boat would be moving. So this would be right below either, for me, I have it mounted on my trolling motor. So this would be right below my trolling motor. But if you have it mounted on the stern of your boat by your outboard, this would be right at the stern of the boat. And then everything behind it would be past your boat. You've already gone over it. A couple people had questions on that. So when I'm actually fishing these, I tied these on about 6 inches apart. As you can see, we got fish right at the bottom here, but they're about 30 feet of water. I was out here yesterday, caught two or three pretty good sized fish in that 11, 12 inch range. And hopefully we can catch some more. But the goal today is just to kind of show you what I'm looking at. Now you have to understand these, too much line. What we're looking at. So understand again, going back to how to find or how to use fishing sonar. Ooh, I got some coming looking at it. This is showing 1/3 the depth because I'm running 200 kilohertz. And the way you figure that out, you go to, this fish might actually hit the thing. You go to your menu setup, you hit it twice and you go over one to where it says sonar. See how it says beam select? That's 200 kilohertz, okay? It's a narrower beam. That's a 20 degree beam on this unit. So, when you're running 200 kilohertz, figure it's about a 20 degree beam, 19 to 20. You take 1/3 the total depth. So my cone, if I can get an above shot of the ice hole here, I'm running about 11, 12 feet, somewhere in there, all around me, right? So the diameter of the cone is 11 to 12 feet. Each side of 6 feet each side of the hole roughly. Now that cone is skinny at the top and wide at the bottom, so that's 12 feet of the surface. But as I bring these jigs up the water column, let's say I'm fishing 20 feet of water, that cone is only 10 feet, okay? So fish in that extra 2 feet, I'm not gonna be able to see. But you can see there's my top jig with the plastic, that little blue mark, blue and purple mark. And then the thicker one, that orange and purple, is my marabou jig. Now these are fish on the bottom. Let's see if I can get one of them to hit here. I don't know if they're gonna hit the marabou or they're gonna hit the plastic. But another benefit of using this double jig setup is you can fish two different depths. I'm 6 inches apart. I can fish two different colors if I want to. And if you're single poling like this, obviously ice fishing is a little different, but if you're single pole jigging in open water, you see me do that a lot of times with the 8-foot or that 10-foot, 10, 11-foot rods. This just allows you to put more bait in the water without worrying about multiple rods. Let's see if I can get one of these guys. Come on.
All right, there we go. I changed angles. Hopefully you can now see the screen a lot better. Not too much glare on it. There's a fish. One thing about this screen, you can't actually zoom into the bottom unless you're on flasher mode. I mean, with the real-time sonar on, you can do it here, and I can see, you know, what I'm jigging. I'm slowly jigging up and down, but this is the only screen I can zoom in on. I'm gonna drop it down, get that plastic in front of their face. Okay, so I wanted to freeze this and start talking about this little white mark here. Eventually, I'm going to do a full video on just flasher units, not just the LCD unit like you see here, where it's an LCD screen, but an actual flasher unit, because I think some of you are, I got some questions about that, whether or not it would be useful on a boat in open water. I think it would be for vertically jigging, but kind of open water and just exploring the lake bottom, I don't think it's very useful. But quick note here that I want to talk about this little white line that I froze here. So this is actually the zoom window, and what happens specifically on the Humminbird units, both on this LCD unit and on the flasher units, like it's just a flasher display, you can actually adjust the window that you zoom in on. So now you can see I'm in 34 feet of water, 35 feet of water. And basically right now, that white mark, there's usually a second one, but I think I have it turned all the way up or all the way down towards the bottom. So that white mark, there's one on the bottom at 29.2 feet, and there's actually one up top at zero. And basically all that did was it zoomed in the bottom part from 29.2 till about 35, which is why my jig looks so big. That green and yellow is the marabou jig, and that blue mark up top is actually the plastic, the smaller jig with the plastic on it. They look like they're covering, you know, a foot of water. That just the marabou jig itself, it looks huge on the screen, but that's only because I zoomed into the bottom. And the cool thing about the Humminbird units, and both Lowrance, Vexilar, Garmin, Markham, they all have some sort of zoom function on them if they do have a flasher unit set up. And the cool thing about this is you can actually adjust if the crappie are suspended. Let's say these crappie were suspended 17 to 20 feet up. I could actually zoom in on that depth of water within that 10-foot range. So let's say 10 to 20 feet. Zoom in. I can actually see the separation a lot better between my jig and a fish. And what that's going to do, it's really going to help you with your jig cadence to determine what the fish actually want to see. And then once you figure out, okay, this is what's making these crappie strike, you can kind of keep that up, that jigging cadence up with whatever bait you're using. So I just want to point that out with this flash unit. I will be doing a further video on it, or a future video on it. All right, so real quick, there's actually two things that I wanted to talk about 2D sonar that actually came up during my 2D sonar videos while I was on the boat this summer. The first one is about color palettes. A lot of people had questions if they were brand new to sonar units. Normally, the darker the color, the bigger the fish, or the stronger the signal when it's reading structure or cover in the water. Now, I actually have this color palette set up that the yellow, that bright yellow, is actually the heaviest, or is reading the heaviest signal, or the strongest signal, meaning the bigger fish are going to show up as yellow. And then it goes orange, I'm trying to see here, orange, red, and purple. So that purple color is actually going to be the lightest fish. If you can see on the top right now, there's a purple color. I think that's my smallest jig in the real-time sonar thing. And then real quick, people ask, why do I have this on? This is the main reason. I'm so used to using it during ice fishing season. You can actually see your jig going up and down. You don't really need a flasher unit. I know that kind of came up. I think another YouTuber was asking me that question, whether they should switch to a flasher unit. Most sonar units have this real-time sonar on the right side of the screen. that actually shows the jig falling if you can get it right below your transducer. That can be hard to do in open water, but ice fishing, obviously, it's pretty easy. Just drop it down the hole. The second thing, real quick, a lot of times I would get questions about why fish would show up as straight lines, even when I was trolling, and that's because the fish were constantly underneath the boat. So this transducer sending a signal, if the fish stay right below that transducer, it constantly gets pinged back that there's an object down there. And this is more profound during ice fishing because obviously I'm not moving anywhere. And if the fish just sits right below the hole, it constantly gets a signal, which is why it shows up as a straight line on the historical data moving from right to left, where normally if you're in a boat and you go over a fish, it's gonna look like an arc. Okay, so those are two things I just wanted to cover real quick. All right, that's actually gonna wrap it up for this video. I know, not really a fish catching video, but I hope you learned something about the 2D sonar, what double jigs should look like on your 2D sonar. I know a lot of you down south, still open water, well, you'll probably always have open water, but a lot of questions on the setup, specifically the double jig setup and what it looked like on the 2D sonar. I hope I answered a few of them. If you have more questions on the 2D sonar, first go watch the How to Find Fish series. It's a fish finder series that I did. And then post in the comment section anything that I missed. I'm gonna still be able to do videos like this one on 2D sonar throughout ice fishing. I won't be able to do side imaging or down imaging with the Humminbird. Yeah, I won't be able to do side imaging or down imaging with the Humminbird until open water season. So those questions I'll save till springtime. But if you have any more questions on the 2D sonar, please post them in the comments below. I just couldn't get them to bite today. It happens. I'm probably going to try a few different plastics. If I can actually catch some fish on different colors, I'll put them in the video. If not, I appreciate you watching. As always, be sure to like and share the video. And if you're new to this channel, click that red subscribe button and click that bell. That bell's going to notify you every time I post a video. All right, that's going to wrap it up. We'll see ya.